Hey, my name is Marcus Grip, and in this video, I'm going to show you the top 10 foods that does not affect your blood sugar. These are both healthy, beneficial, and of course perfect for people with both types of diabetes. Before we get started, I just wanted to share a quick little tip for you who are just starting out with eating healthier and different, and that have a hard time getting rid of all the carbohydrates, because I know it's pretty hard. So a great thing with protein and fat is that it slows down the conversion from food to blood sugar, which means if you're still eating carbohydrates, even though I recommend trying to get rid of as much as possible, you can add fat and protein to your meal to slow down the absorption of carbohydrates, which means you will not get a strong peak in the blood sugar as you would have with the carbohydrates alone. Now, that said, it still will affect your blood sugar, of course, but just for you who hasn't started out or have 100% commitment, it's a step in the right direction. Now, let's look at those top 10 foods that does not affect the blood sugar. Bear in mind that this list has no specific order, and the first or last one doesn't mean that they're best or healthiest or worst or bad or something like that. It's just the way I made it. Okay, so number one, onion and garlic. Onion and garlic is very healthy and beneficial, and is actually the food that has less pesticides and chemicals on them of the conventional food, if you feel that organic food is too expensive, which makes it cheaper and easier to buy since it's not that big difference between the organic ones and the conventional ones. And I think that's because of the shell that they have, so they don't feel that they have to, because that shell is a natural protection, so that's the reason why that is. So garlic is really awesome for tons of stuff. It helps, for example, with high cholesterol, poor digestion, diabetes and blood sugar, of course that's important for us, yeast infections, boost immune system, increased absorption of iron and zinc, antioxidants, cold and flu, it's antifungal, parasites, allergies, and so on. It's like, it's a miracle thing. Back in the old days, you know, I'm talking like hundreds and thousands of years back, this was used a lot by doctors since, you know, already then, because they knew how great garlic was. Onions are a very good source of vitamin C, B6, biotin, chromium, calcium, and dietary fiber. In addition, they contain good amounts of folic acid and vitamin B1 and K. So it's also a great help for the liver. So, you know, both onion and garlic are amazing and they really help. And I eat that almost every day because I know how great it is. Okay, so number two, let's keep on going. Leafy greens. You know, this is the most important part of my meals. Leafy greens are so healthy, full of micronutrients like vitamins and minerals. They are very beneficial for the body in so many ways, and they are alkaline, which supports a tremendous amount of health, especially in this world where most all normal food is so acid for our bodies. So this is just pure superfood with no effects on the blood sugar. I use it in smoothies, salads, on side dishes to anything else. You know, I make burritos with the leafy greens. It's just awesome for everything. Okay, so number three, fatty seeds. Healthy seeds full of healthy fats like flax seeds, pumpkin seeds, sunflower seeds, chia seeds, and alfalfa seeds are super healthy and are very high in fat and protein, and have either no carbs or very low amount of carbs, and almost exclusively all of those carbs are dietary fiber. And according to my experience with seeds, and also according to nutritiondata.self.com, which is a huge database with food and their nutritions and information and stuff, these seeds have no glycemic load, which is a number that they use to measure how much it affects the blood sugar. So basically it doesn't affect the blood sugar at all, but it's super healthy. So next time you put cereal in your yogurt, replace that with some great seeds, or just eat them as they are, as snacks. So number four, avocados. This is truly my candy throughout the day. It's delicious, can be used in many, many ways, and easy to prepare and eat. Have as a snack, or, you know, whatever you want. Avocado is full of healthy vitamins and minerals as well, and also have a great amount of healthy fatty acids, omega-3 and 6, which is very important. It's also full of vitamin A, C, E, K, B6, folate, and it's also anti-inflammatory. So that's great. Okay, so number five, coconut. If you eat the raw meat, cocoa flakes, or the coconut oil, you will not have to worry about your blood sugar, since coconut has a high amount of fat and almost all the carbs are dietary fiber, and has basically no glycemic load at all. So I always use coconut oil if I cook something, which is very rarely because I'm a high raw food eater. And I also just eat it as it is, like the coconut oil and the coconut fat. I actually eat it as it is. But I also use it, you know, you can use it for baking raw desserts of some sort and stuff like that. So it has several uses and it's very healthy for you. So it's awesome. Just make sure it's organic with all the stuff here. I'm going to mention that many, many times in my videos, but that's very important. I think that's a big health changer for you. So, okay. Number 6 is nuts. Nuts like walnuts, hazelnuts, peanuts, or almonds are super high in healthy fats and proteins as well. They have barely any carb, which again is just dietary fiber, and is very anti-inflammatory. Short said, nuts are very healthy, great snacks that doesn't mess with your blood sugar. You know, you can have them in yogurt as well, but just be a little more careful with the cashew as they tend to have more carbs. But again, it's nothing like a glass of juice or a Snickers bar or something like that. But I've seen a little raise sometimes in my blood sugar with cashew. But it also depends how much you eat, you know. I really go nuts, literally speaking, and eat like 100 or 200 grams of it because it's delicious. And I eat it as a snack or, between meals. So it makes sense since the glycemic load is 11 per 100 gram. And if the glycemic load number is over 15, it is classified as, you know, affecting your blood sugar. So it's close to that kind of limit, but the other ones are no problem. But just to make sure, like cashew are a little more, but still way more healthy and way less sweet and have less effect on your blood sugar than a glass of juice or Snickers bars or candies like that. Okay, so number 7 is herbs like basil, cilantro, oregano, mint, lemon balm, and so on. You know, all kinds of herbs are very good because they have basically no macronutrients, which is, you know, the proteins, the fats, and the carbs, but instead have a lot of vitamins and minerals. So they have no effect on the blood sugar, but gives great taste to the food, of course, because that's how we usually use them. And they have healthy vitamins and minerals and a lot of cleansing and healing properties. So make sure they are organic and fresh, or do as I do, you know, plant your own. That's awesome, because not only is it fun, I love to have my own plants and take care of them like my own little babies, but it also saves you money. So, you know, if you want to save money, plant your own stuff. And you just buy some organic seed, plant it, and then you can see the whole process. You can be part of it. And you, like, I have my awesome basil plant. I take some leaves, and then I let it grow more, take some more leaves, and, you know, it's great. So make sure you use a lot of herbs in your food, fresh organic herbs to spice it up with, because it's going to give you a lot of bonus health properties. So, number 8, eggs. A great source of the very essential vitamin B12 and a good amount of protein and fat comes from eggs. No effect on the blood sugar and a great way to start the day, and they're easy to cook and cheap as well. So, you know, what's not to love? Just be careful not to eat too much, since eggs are a dairy product, which makes our body acids, so compensate with an avocado and some salad to it. And that's basically what I have for breakfast, and I love it. So here's number 9. Again, this is top 10 foods that doesn't affect the blood sugar, and even though you might know I promote a very high alkaline diet, for some people, or in some times, you have to use some dairy products, and that's okay, as long as it's not more than the alkaline food and not too often, if you want to go for a really serious health with the alkaline diet style. So here goes number 9, which is butter and cheese. And I'm talking real, real butter without any additives, not margarine. So real, real butter that is high in fat and is just, you know, pure butter. Cheese is a little harder to mess around with, but even though the animals that the cheese is made from can have been treated badly and been fed growth hormones, which of course affects the outcome of the cheese products, so make sure it's organic here as well. The growth hormones is going to affect the animal, and that's going to affect the cheese where it comes from. So make sure everything is organic, and that's going to benefit you a lot, especially in the long term. So the last but not least, number 10, is oils. Okay, oils are 100% fat, and you got to be very delicate and careful with what you choose. I only use organic coconut oil, organic cold-pressed extra virgin olive oil, or organic hemp oil. I always make sure that it's organic, high quality and nothing bogus in it, because using normal conventional like sunflower oil or palm oil and all those other, and even olive oil, you know, is the conventional ones, all of those weird, you know, when they even mixed oils are just pure crap and bottles of chemical shitstorm, frankly speaking. So but the good ones are fantastic to have on your food to spice up the flavor. If you have to cook and you're not like high raw food like me, it's great for cooking. And of course my favorite, make your own pesto. It's, you know, you need olive oil for pesto, so I usually make my own, which is delicious. So I use my organic olive oil to make it, and it's awesome, and I can have it for everything. It makes my salad taste like heaven. So okay, now you've been going through the top 10 foods that doesn't affect your blood sugar, and you also saw what health benefits and properties they have. It's like a little bonus. So a quick recap. Number one, onions and garlic, great body cleansers in so many ways. Okay, number two, leafy greens. These are just made for everything and is truly superfood. Number three, seeds. Can be used in several ways, full of great fats and vitamins and minerals. Number four is avocado, and that's my personal favorite. That is perfect snack or side dish to any meal. And then you have number five, which is coconut, full of fat, delicious flavor, and comes in many ways and forms like oils, fat, flakes, flour, and so on. Number six is nuts. Great snack and replacement for candy, and great to have instead of cereal or granola in your yogurt or milk. And actually, nuts can also come in flour, so you can use it for baking and stuff like that. Number seven is herbs. Most full of micronutrients instead of protein, fats, and carbs, and of course spice up the food and make it more alive, and has ways to benefit the body and your overall health. Okay, so number eight is eggs. It's perfect for breakfast, a lot of uses in baking and cooking, and a great source of the essential vitamin B12. Number nine is butter and cheese, and it's acid for the body, so keep it in moderation, but as you know, has many uses in our lives, and cheese is delicious to freaking everything, in my opinion. So, full of fat, no problems for the blood sugar. That's it. And number 10, which is oils that we also have great use for in our kitchen in many ways. And as I always recommend, keep everything you buy as local, as clean, from chemicals, and as organic as possible. And even consider growing your own in your garden. It's really not that hard. And I will make a video about that in the future. But until then, Google can offer you pretty significant amount of help. So Google around and see what you can find, but I'm gonna make a video about that too. So if you're a subscriber, you're gonna know about it. So I hope this video gave you a lot of value and help, and if I did, please like the video on the button below. So thank you for watching. My name is Marcus Grip, and talk to you soon.